to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new here. My name is Kirsten and I'm 26 years old and I live in Southwest Florida. I make videos pretty much about anything and everything you can think of. I make videos about health, fitness, school, work, volunteering, all sorts of different things, depending on what I feel like doing that day. Also, we are so close to 2,000 subscribers and I am going to be doing a 2,000 subscriber giveaway. I'm going to be giving away a Kindle, a Brewmate, and some Sunbun products. So don't forget to subscribe and like the video down below. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram. I post stuff there all the time and I'm constantly like storying and I've gotten into Instagram reels. It's just a good time for me. Today's video is going to be a little bit more chill, a little bit more relaxed. I'm actually going to be going back to Virginia for a week when you're seeing this, so I'm trying to pre-film some content for y'all, but I don't like to just like film stuff just to put it out there. I want it to actually be useful, helpful information. Today's video is going to be 5 tips on how to help grow your YouTube channel. And these are not tips that I have gotten from other videos or watching other people. These are 5 things that I did that I feel like helped my channel grow. But if you don't know, my channel is monetized. There's ads on it, but I got monetized within 9 months of posting regularly to YouTube. I hit the 1,000 subscribers and the 4,000 watch hours relatively quickly. I know some people hit it faster than that, but I feel like 9 months is quicker, especially when some people have been posting regularly for years. So I just wanted to talk about the 5 biggest things that stuck out in my mind to help grow your channel. And maybe you can implement some of these things into your channel and it'll help you grow. And also, don't mind my appearance. I've been running around all day, packing, washing clothes, cleaning my house, and just doing all of the things, you know, before a trip anywhere. So also, if you see me looking down, I have my notes down here. Let's just get into the video. So the first tip that I have for you guys, and this is actually something that I have heard other people talk about, but I really went through this with my channel in the beginning, and that is to be as niche as possible. When I first started my YouTube channel, all of my videos were about dental assisting. I was a dental assisting student and I was pushing out so much dental assisting content, and there wasn't very much on YouTube. So I was searching and I was searching and I couldn't find anybody to watch, and I was like, well, why don't I just make videos then? I started pumping out super niche dental assisting student content and my channel grew very quickly. And I also have some examples for you of how to do this. You should really narrow down something that you love to do, whether it's a hobby or your job, or you know, if you're in school, or like what your major is in college or something like that, and really just hone in on that subject, at least in the beginning of your channel until you get monetized. It's really gonna help your channel grow if people know that they can come to your channel to find answers and information on a certain topic. So I just wrote some notes here. Say your hobby is fitness, and I know this feels super saturated on YouTube anyway, but the type of videos you can make, meal prepping videos, showing the healthy meals you prep for the week, whether you work full time and people wanna know what you're eating to stay fit. You could try different fitness challenges like the Chloe Ting challenge. There's so many different fitness challenges out there, so you could definitely film videos based on that. You could also do healthy grocery hauls and meal planning videos. You could do fitness favorites, so if you have favorite workout clothes, favorite equipment, favorite like gadgets like earbuds for working out or resistance bands, things like that. So if you're constantly putting out that sort of content, like people that are obsessed with fitness, which is a lot, they are gonna know they can come to your channel for information that they want. Another example I have, say like for me, I'm a business major. You can talk about internships, you can talk about business classes, you can talk about how you're preparing for the future, you can talk about if you wanna start your own business. So you're a business major and you wanna be an entrepreneur. Talk about the processes of how you're gonna do that. Educate yourself so you can educate people on certain topics. Show them a day in the life of a business student, things like that. I know some people do get successful on like lifestyle and that sort of stuff, but I feel like for the most part in the beginning, people have super niche channels and that's how they explode. My second tip for you is to create meaningful relationships with your subscribers. So a lot of my subscribers follow me on Instagram and I follow them back and I message them on Instagram. We comment on each other's pictures. We talk in the comments of my videos. I have made friends from people from YouTube, and I think it was really important in the beginning, especially with my dental assisting videos, because a lot of people had questions and I made sure to answer their questions, and I made sure if I didn't know the information, I went and found it and then gave them the information. That kind of helped us build trust and a relationship, and it kept them coming back because they knew that I was there for them and I was putting out content for them and that I actually cared about them, because I do. I care about all my subscribers and I see regular faces in my comments. I see regular faces on my Instagram. It has definitely become more of like a community. If you're just posting videos and you're like not talking to your subscribers, or you're like leaving not very personal comments and responding back, I just feel like that's not how you should grow. If people are taking the time to watch and comment on your videos, you should take the time to curate a response that's meaningful towards that, and then people will keep coming back because you're building a relationship. My third tip is to post regularly, and this can even just be like once a week or even once every other week. I would rather someone put out one video a week than four videos a week. If their one video is more meaningful, you can tell that they took a lot of time and effort into making it. If it's packed full of information, as long as you're consistent and your subscribers know that they're gonna be able to watch some of your content every week, I think that will definitely help your channel grow. When I started posting regularly dental assisting videos, that's when my channel really took off and some of my videos kind of went viral. I don't wanna say like, not super viral, but like, I think that the video with the most views on my channel has almost 50,000 views on it. And that was the first dental assisting video I posted, and it kind of got that big. And I honestly can't believe it, because I feel like I look like such a turd in it. Well, not a turd, but like, I'm so nervous and just like, hey. Posting regularly, like I said, like talking about before, it helps build a relationship with your subscribers, and you're building consistency and they're seeing your face every week or twice a week or three times a week, whatever your posting schedule is. And it doesn't even have to be on the same days every week or at the same time. Just knowing that they're going to get a video from you and it's going to be a part of their routine of their week, I also think that definitely helps grow your channel. The fourth tip that I have for you guys: if a subscriber requested a video down below that I knew I could film for them or create for them, I definitely took it into account a lot of times. So many of the videos I put up were videos that people requested in the comments. So by me putting up videos that people asked for, it showed that I wanted to help them and that I cared about what they said, because I would take the time to research and post videos for them. Or I would also often ask my subscribers what they wanted to see from me, and they would leave requests down below and I would make sure to film them, because there's nothing better than to put out videos that your subscribers wanna see and that you know is going to help them. Subscribers like to be heard. If you have subscribers in your comments asking you to do certain videos and you're comfortable and you think you would enjoy doing it, definitely start putting those up on your channel so your subscribers know that you're listening and that you wanna help them or entertain them. The fifth tip that I have for you guys for growing your YouTube channel is to show the good and the bad. There's nothing worse than someone who only shows an unrealistic version of their life. I understand some people only wanna put positivity out onto the internet, which is completely fine. But if you are completely like faking your life or making your life look perfect when in reality, like nobody's life is perfect, people don't wanna see that. Or if they do, it eventually all unravels and people realize that you were just putting on a show for everyone. For me, I put out both the good and the bad. When good things happened, or when I learned new things, I put it out there. When bad things happened or I had a bad day, I also put it out there, because that's who I am and that's my life. And I just wanted to be as authentic as possible to the people watching my video. This can be really hard to do sometimes, but I feel like once you've built a relationship with your subscribers, you know you can put out when you're having a bad day or when something bad has happened, because 99.9% of the people are gonna be there for you and be supportive. And that's really something that I have been so grateful for, because my subscribers have been so supportive. Even when my channel shifted from dental assisting to more lifestyle, they were still supportive and wanted to watch my videos, and it really meant a lot to me. So I don't even know how to like repay the people, because it made me want to open up more and be more honest and real with you guys. So definitely showing people the good and bad parts of their life, of a career. I mean, not necessarily like doing something that will get you fired from your job, which we all know I've been down that road before. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it was super short and sweet, and hopefully you got some information out of it. And if you are starting a YouTube channel or you want to start a YouTube channel, you can definitely leave questions down below. I'll answer any questions you have. Obviously, I'm not like a huge YouTuber, but I do make money from this as like a side hustle. and my channel is growing. I feel like I can probably help some people in some way, and that's all I ever want to do is help people succeed, because I think that we should all be lifting each other up. Once again, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I literally cannot wait to do a giveaway. So along with the prizes that I said in the beginning, I'm also going to be Venmoing someone $50. So there'll be technically two winners. So make sure to subscribe so we can get to that giveaway, like the video, and follow me on Instagram. I love you guys so much. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.